Hello and welcome to Views from the Market, Mid-Market Private Equity and M&A in Canada. My name is Mario Negro, and I'm a partner in the Private Equity and M&A group at Stikeman Elliott. For today's podcast, I'd like to welcome our special guest, Liz MacRae. Liz is the president and co-founder of Village Wellth. Liz, welcome and thank you for joining us.
Thanks so much, Mario.
Liz, you're based in Calgary, but you have rich history that got you to Village Wellth. And I want to start by talking a little bit about your history and then talking about Village Wellth.
Sure. Yeah. Originally from Prince Edward Island out on the East Coast and made my way out west in about 2007 for work and other purposes. And then juggled between Alberta and the East Coast for a few years. And then about 10 years ago, we finally settled for a longer term in Calgary. But my business ownership journey started out east when we were starting a family just about 12 years ago and wanted to be closer to family and bought a business in Atlantic Canada in the Halifax area. And we bought a franchise and we learned trial by fire that we should have bought an existing business and we should have done ETA. But hindsight is 2020, and that's kind of how my journey started, was by going about things a different way. And that's what empowers me to be in the ETA space now. Is I'm extremely passionate that I believe everyone who's pursuing entrepreneurship in one way or another should know about acquisitions. Firm believer in it. I think everywhere that it is in education, there should be a thread that acquisition is a pathway. Really passionate about the space.
So tell us about how you created Village Wellth and about Village Wellth and what it's doing, and particularly obviously in Calgary where home is, but tell us a bit about the history of Village Wellth and what it's doing today.
Yeah, so Village Wellth is an acquisition management platform. We have a number of different tools and functionality to the platform, as well as we manage a community of Canadian acquirers. For the most part, we work with first-time acquirers, first-time searchers who've never bought a business before. Most of them have come from corporate, or maybe they've, you know, done startups before and had an exit, or done startups and still own companies but have just never bought a business before. And my partners and I came together. 2019 is when we started the conversation about Village Wellth. We looked around and we came from backgrounds in finance and wealth management and business brokering. I was a business broker before being in Village Wellth, and it was just kind of a constant conversation where I was talking to buyers and it was the same thing every week, talking to the same buyers. And it just didn't seem like they had any place, any home, anywhere to connect with other buyers, and very little presence. So when my partners and I connected, one of my partners had another technology platform and he would pair investors with financial planners, and the investors had anonymous profiles. And we thought, well, what if we could create something in the buy side space of acquisitions where buyers had more presence? And what if we created this marketplace where anyone selling a business could access buyers, and buyers had these profiles that were publicly accessible and anyone could see them, but they were anonymous? And so that's kind of how the journey of Village Wellth started. And we built this marketplace. Being a startup, you know, you learn some lessons and pivot a few times. And what we've evolved into has been kind of a direct correlation of what our members keep asking us for. So where we've evolved to now is the marketplace is free to use and it's a tool. We've got M&A firms and brokers and some business owners using it across the country. But what we've really morphed into is advisory and debt advisory. So when people were finding deals, but they weren't finding them through us in the beginning, they were finding them, you know, anywhere. And then they would come back and then go, well, now what? Now what do I do? How do I structure this? How do we get financing? What's the next step? Do you have a lawyer for me? What are all these things? So we've evolved our offerings and we're still building technology and we're still building tools and things into the platform. But that's where we are today.
Liz, what I really appreciate or admire about Village Wellth is it really is trying to do that outreach, or be there, maybe in another way, be there for that person who wants to be an entrepreneur through acquisition, but just doesn't know where to start. Like, we don't have enough of that in Canada. We don't have some of the institutional resources that exist in the US. And so Village Wellth's role is magnified in our marketplace because there's just very few resources like it. So tell us a little bit more about, you know, that gap that you're filling. You see it every day, right? Entrepreneurs who want to do, but don't know where to go. Yeah. I see it too. And my people call me and say, I want to buy a business. They know the elements of it, but they don't know the resources. They don't know how to move forward. Anyway, I wanted to get your thoughts on, you know, that gap, how you see Village Wellth filling it, and where you see more of the need for.
absolutely. And, you know, I think in the last number of years, there's been more resources and communities evolve, mostly in the US. And that's where we saw a gap for certain in the Canadian market, too, is at the time when we started, there wasn't much for community. Yeah, where's that starting point? So we do start very early on. We start when people are just at ideation. So we have a membership program that offers a course to get people started. We run live cohorts so that we're there with them through the course offering. So, you know, when someone says, what is this buying a business thing? We're like, okay, you can start with us. You know, this can be your ground zero and you can start to kind of get educated and get resources. We invite in expert advisors, accountants, tax planners, everything at every junction to do webinars. And so our content library is fairly robust now after the last few years of doing this. We've got a fantastic content library. And then our course where people could get started. But what we find too is when we talk to a lot of people, they're in the search phase. So we break it down into five phases. And, you know, people are, when they come to us and they're in search phase, what we often find is they've skipped over their planning and they've skipped over, you know, not just building their search criteria, but their short-term and their long-term goals and how they are presenting themselves in the market and branding themselves. You know, you're going to go look for a business to buy. And we hear it all the time. It's like, well, how do you find businesses to buy? Or I'm seeing all the same listings. And there are multiple strategies to find businesses to buy, but it's part looking for a business. It's part hunting and it's part personal branding too. And there's more buyers entering the market and there's lots of companies to go around, but you got to present yourself well too. And so we teach people how to present themselves, how to build relationships. We teach them how to tap their network. We teach them where they can source deals. We teach them about proprietary outreach and what that looks like, as well as what to expect in the market. You know, what's the difference between engaging with a business broker versus an M&A firm? How are they going to view you? How are they going to perceive you? How do you get through the gatekeepers? How do you build credibility for yourself and all those things of how to get started in search? That's what we often find is people have skipped over some of the planning phases and they've just jumped right into search. So we kind of take them back to ground zero. But some people who are a little bit more sophisticated and they're like, I've got my advisors, I've got investors, I've got the know-how, I just need more deal flow. So that's where some people are just jumping into our marketplace and they're registering their search. So when someone registers their search with us, then on the sell side, when a deal gets loaded into the system, there's an algorithm that will pair them. And so that buyer will get notified that there's a new deal in the system that could be a match for them. But also the way that our system works is a little bit unique in that sellers don't have to publish a listing. So we've got some of the bigger accounting firms and their deals are, you know, a little bit more proprietary or confidentiality is more of a factor. And so they don't publish. So they will curate a buyer list on Village Wellth of the buyer profiles and then they'll reach out. So there's two ways to use our marketplace. One is you're searching for deal flow or getting notifications that something's new. And the other way is that sellers will reach out to you and you'll receive a private message on your dashboard and behind the scenes.
Liz, I want to drill down on your five key stages because there's a few key points of those five. I know we've talked about the planning, we've talked about the searching. If you could just briefly tell us the other three stages that you focus on.
Yeah, so we bundle them into evaluation. So, you know, you're starting to look at deals, you're starting to go through sims and financials and that evaluation stage. Pre-LOI. And so stage four is the LOI stage, negotiations, bring it all together. And stage five is financing due diligence.
I want to talk a bit about financing because I know that's, again, one of the unique characteristics about Village Wellth is you're not just showing people deal opportunities. You're part of the whole process. And of course, a lot of time for entrepreneurs in our marketplace, finding capital, finding lenders is sometimes the biggest hurdle. What are you seeing in the marketplace? You've seen the marketplace evolve. I want to get your thoughts on the fundraising and financing processes in our marketplace for these kind of entrepreneurs buying businesses in the lower middle market.
We've certainly have seen it shift. I'd say more significantly within the last 2 years, we've started to see the lending space in Canada shift. That's where when someone gets to the LOI stage, that's where our service switches. So we have an upgrade where people who are really highly motivated to acquire and want some extra bench strength, that's where we'll come in with our advisory team and work with them through deal structuring from a bankability standpoint. And so then we'll take them through the finance process and build their financing package and tender them out to lenders and work on the debt advisory part of the process. once you get under LOI, you know, the clock is ticking and you're doing due diligence and you're managing the legal and the financial due diligence. And it's busy. It's really busy. And so we take some of the burden off and manage the finance pieces. We've seen it become more competitive. We've seen loan to value increase. We've seen the amount of personal capital that is a requirement, where we used to hear that it was, you know, we needed 15 to 20% of personal equity into the deal. We've seen that decrease to less than 10% in some cases. We've seen more seller financing if it's deferred and it's patient. We've seen it be considered as buyer's equity. And we've seen some interesting things from principal holiday perspective too, you know, where it gives the acquirer some grace period in the first 6 to 12 months. We really like to see that because it really does give someone the opportunity to get ahead of their cash flow. And then on the equity side, it's still a new environment in Canada. I think we're starting to see more investors become aware of it, that you can co-invest with acquisition entrepreneurs. I think it's a really exciting time to be in this space. Heads are starting to turn toward acquisition. I've had multiple conversations within the last couple of weeks with previous VC investors who are pivoting their entire business model toward acquisitions and co-investment. We've seen international funds that were looking at VC investment pivot to acquisitions. And then another observation that we've seen is we've seen more families doing this together. We've seen fathers participating with their daughters, either from an advisory or a co-investment standpoint, which has been a pattern that for me as a woman entrepreneur, it's been fascinating to pick up and notice that trend. We have a father who bought a manufacturing company last year, who's just brought his daughter into the company with him. So that's been an interesting bit of a side story, but it's certainly something that we're seeing a pattern in. Yeah, it's been an interesting trajectory for us to be a part of, and it continues to evolve.
Liz, Village Wellth is about 5 years old. You know, if I can ask you a bit about what you've seen in terms of growth in the last 5 years, and then I'm going to lead that into, I always ask our guests the crystal ball question about where they see this is going. And obviously, you sound excited. I'll be surprised if I hear it's not, you know, you're not excited about where it's going, but get your perspectives on, you've seen your site, you've seen the work you're doing, you've seen the number of people involved. I want to get a feel for you in terms of the kind of growth from where you sit, but then also, where do you think this is going? Where do you see the next kind of wave, the next stage?
Yeah, from what we've seen, I think the space is certainly growing. Like, the awareness of ETA is certainly growing, and it's not slowing down. It's growing faster. And as you and I have chatted, and we've been on panels together, private equity started out with one. It was one acquisition at a time. Everyone starts with one. Everyone starts with their first one. And I think it is getting more competitive. But, you know, there's millions of businesses that need to transition. There's a lot to go around. I think where we're going to see the necessity of buyers is to niche down. And I think we see that is where we see people starting out in search funds, or whether they're self-funded or they are a search fund, we usually see them come down market. We usually see them start high because that's what they're hearing and that's what they're being taught. And then we see them niche down and come down market a little bit. Is something that we've seen. I think it's going to be important for searchers to continue to be more specific about what they're looking for and continue to find other ways to differentiate themselves. I think the innovation of search is still, like, there's no silver bullet. There's no one-stop shop. And I think, you know, people are still hoping for that. I want to find a business to buy. Can you help me find a business? Like, there's lots of different tools and strategies. It's a process. It's an investment of time and resources. There's a big difference between, I think, people who are thinking about this path and people who have taken action and committed to it. There's a threshold, and you can tell when people have crossed the threshold and really committed and are going to make a real stab at this. It's fascinating to observe the behaviors in the space too. The crystal ball, what do I see happening? I think we're going to see greater pathways to debt and equity across the board. Those programs will continue to evolve. And I think we have to do it to scale. And I think we are starting to see in Canada, we're seeing more nonprofit business associations catch wind of this. The CFIB report, the Canadian Federation of Independent Business report, kicked things into gear a couple of years ago. I think that came out maybe 18 months ago now. And I think BDC and other organizations have been saying this for years. And I'm sorry, I don't know completely where your listenership is, if it's US or Canadian based or both. But the Canadian ecosystem is certainly paying more attention to the succession movement that's happening. We're starting to see the banks respond more. We're starting to see investors explore what this market looks like. So I think it's really exciting time. I think we'll see more access, more clarity, more refinement, more streamlined tools. We're in the space. That's what we're trying to do. We're on a mission to make acquisitions, capital, debt, and equity more accessible, much more accessible at scale. You know, 12 years ago, this option wasn't available to myself. And, you know, that's what keeps me coming to work every day to make sure it's available for a lot of people going forward.
Liz, I want to thank you for joining us. It's been great to learn about the work you do in Village Wellth. And I'm super excited to see where Village Wellth goes and the roles it continues to play in terms of the evolution of entrepreneurship through acquisition in Canada. Thank you for your insight. And I hope to see Village Wellth just continue to grow and prosper.
Thank you. Well, thank you for everything that you do, Mario. I hear your name on a regular basis, and I know that so many people have been touched through your work and are so appreciative of the role you play in the space. So thank you for all that you do.